Innsbruck, the fabled Austrian city deep in the Tyrolean Alps. 1,000 athletes from 36 nations opened the 9th Winter Games in a colorful pageantry. Then the games began. The competition, the stress and sin at its peak. That's the way it always is at these games. And out of the struggle comes respect for one another and the seeds of understanding among peoples. Against the background of some breathtaking scenery, the ski jumper seemed about to take wing and soar out over the city far below. The Norwegians and Finns, seemingly born and raised on skis, dominated these events from the start. When you're still in your high school years, it's asking a lot to represent your country in the world's toughest competition. But these American youngsters accepted the challenge and gave everything they had. Our figure skaters were a teenage team. Only one had reached the ripe old age of 21. Scotty Allen, age 14, took a bronze medal in the men's division. The biathlon is a comparatively new event, skiing over a 12-mile course and shooting at 20 targets along the way. The longest cross-country is 50 kilometers, or about 31 miles. And try that before breakfast some morning. The luge is a new sledding event on the program, and a brand new sport to most Americans. The always thrilling bobsled runs, sensational times were chalked up by the leading teams. During their 3-week stay at Innsbruck, all the athletes had time for sightseeing. For the friendly young Americans, it was all new, all exciting, a vivid period in their lives that would never be forgotten. And the people of Austria wouldn't soon forget them either. Speaking of memorable moments, here is Terran speed skater. The Soviets had won the 500-meter event in the last two Olympics in a row, but not today. As McDermott burned the corners of the turns and then winged down the stretch, everyone knew the USA was on its way. It was a new Olympic record, a gold medal, and for our team, a fitting climax to the 1964 Winter Olympics.